So what if I told you there is an extremely rare, low-quantity pressed Future Funk vinyl record that exists that is being sold for $1,000? Yep, that's right, that's four digits, that's a lot of dinero right there. Today we're gonna take a look at this mysterious hidden piece of physical music and see just why this thing is so expensive. Is having something that is hit with such a high price tag actually worth it? Let's dive into it and what we know about Awkwafina's 2016 release of Discotrack's EP, Classic Future Funk Volume 1. Hearing stories of folks paying large sums of money for rare or specific cuts of physical music is no stranger to the lore of music collectors these days, as I'm sure we all know of those cases like the $2 million Wu-Tang Clan album or first initial pressings of certain Beatle vinyl records. But in regards to underground internet spawn genres such as future funk, vaporwave, and more, it's pretty incredible when you hear of instances of physical releases being worth so much money after they sold out from their initial source. When looking at these specific genres, it's obviously key to note that almost any project, album, or EP released within the future funk or vaporwave community is pretty much always done at a pretty low run. This is due to the genres being pretty underground and not necessarily huge commercial successes. It's not like major record labels are funding to supply the product or mainstream radio stations are advertising the music, but many cases, individual artists themselves are producing their music on low cassette runs or reaching out to various vinyl production sources such as Q-Rates, for example, producing them at just enough an amount to not necessarily destroy their wallets and also keep them under the radar of copyright issues. It's a pretty wild concept to think about, as hundreds of thousands of pieces of music are being sold and distributed on such a massive scale, you know, taking place above the surface, and it's us future funk and vaporwave heads who lurk deep below the ground in a society of our own, creating hype and value to our own creations of music. That being said, when looking at specific drops we've seen throughout our history, obvious cases come up, such as Macintosh Plus's Floral Shop, where original cassettes of the album are selling for hundreds of dollars, as well as the Old English Spelling Bee vinyl pressing of the record is also going for over $100, I would say, on eBay right now. I haven't checked in so long. Also, we got the classic Saint Pepsi's Hit Vibe vinyl pressing, which is going for a couple hundred as well. But one album I discovered within the past couple of months, which is definitely pretty eye-catching and interesting, is the extremely limited 100 pressed vinyl record of the Discotrack's EP, Classic Future Funk Volume 1. It's a 6-track and, like the title says, classic sounding and simple future funk release by Portuguese artist Awkwafina. I'm gonna put a link to the original Bandcamp page for the EP in the description of this video if you want to take a listen to the EP, and you can also see where the original long sold out vinyl post is. If you check it out, you're definitely gonna get that traditional future funk experience. It kind of reminds me of early Daft Punk, like the nightclub style production, cruddy bass drums and claps, piercing hi-hats, and way too much reverb on the samples. It's definitely something someone would say these days is just another case of lazy future funk, but even so, it does have a charm and sounds like a fun return to Future Funk's French House roots, which I know I can listen to any day. Not much is really known about the vinyl pressing itself. We do know there were 100 made and they were sold at $20 a piece, but looking online, it's extremely difficult to get any proof of anyone owning this thing or posting a picture or talking about it. It's kind of funny because we all from time to time love to discuss the occurrences of extreme prices of specific drops of music within the community of Future Funk and Vaporwave, but I feel like no one ever talks about this thing. There's nothing about it. Does anyone even have it? Does it even exist? When doing an image search on Google for the EP or the vinyl, the only pictures of the vinyl record that I could find are the two images the Bandcamp page provides. Nothing from an actual buyer or collector or anything linking to an article talking about it or a page or anything. As of making this video, Discogs does have two of these highly sought Disco House bad boys for sale, both by the same owner and both set at a ridiculous $999 plus shipping without any further images of the actual product on that listing. It's definitely a little fishy, as this is the only place I can seem to find something regarding this pressing to exist, and would absolutely love to see if anyone can step forward and provide some more info or examples of this thing actually being real. But what makes this thing worth so much? Is it purely because of its low quantity and being one of the first future funk pieces of music to be pressed onto vinyl? As of right now in 2018, we've seen an explosion of vinyl releases from both vaporwave and future funk artists, and labels and consumers themselves are starting to realize how powerful reliable and profitable these methods of musical distribution can be. Neon City Records and My Pet Flamingo, just to name a few of the small record labels who are taking charge and getting some of our favorite future funk albums out on vinyl. And with all these records coming out so fast in the present day and filling up our shelves, eventually, and it's obviously happening now, more and more attention is going to be placed on getting vinyl pressings of the first sort of releases within this genre of music. St. Pepsi's beloved Hit Vibes, for example, was released a couple years back at a run of 1,000, 500 on standard black and 500 on red. And besides the fact that it's just a really good album, people have created such an overvalued yet socially acceptable price tag for it because it's undeniably fueled by it being one of the first of its kind for the genre. A future funk, vaporwave, vinyl pressing. Collectors will always want one of the first of its kind in any field or hobby, and with Awkwafina's Disco Tracks EP, it is no exception to that rule. It's extremely low run, mysterious whereabouts, and the fact that it's an early future funk release in regards to the vinyl pressing timeline has slapped it with this $1,000 price tag. But does it actually exist? Will anyone ever buy that Discogs listing? Will light be shed on proof of this thing, you know, just being somewhere, and if it was actually sold on that Bandcamp page? And most importantly, what's next for releases, and will we ever see something come out or eventually raise in price that exceeds the value of this current record? Much love, your boy, Pad Chennington.